So far, everything that we've done has been kind of just in the interface tab. And the problem is that when we write all those commands in the command center, and then we close out NetLogo, as you may have found out, when you come back in, it's no longer there and you no longer have those commands. And so what we need to do is we need to start editing in the code tab, which is where we can then save off the results into a model file. And so the code that we're writing will be preserved for when we want to modify it again in the future. So let's click on over to the code tab. And the code tab is where, as you might expect, we actually write the code. And what we do is we define procedures, and procedures are like new commands for the NetLogo model. And there are two procedures that we almost always define right off the bat. And they are the same as the two buttons you see in almost every NetLogo model, which is setup and go. And you define a procedure by starting with the word to, and then you write the name of the procedure. And then when you're done with the procedure, you write the word end. And so I'm going to just go ahead and put stubs in for our setup and go procedures that we have right here. And as you can see, right, the model automatically, or the NetLogo code tab automatically indents you a couple of spaces right at the beginning of each of the procedures. And what this is, standard NetLogo style to kind of indent a little bit each procedure or sub piece of code within the model by two spaces. And so that way it makes it easier to see kind of when the format is changing. So one of the first things you always write in a setup procedure is you write the clear all command, or you can just abbreviate it CA if you want, right? And what that does is destroy the model state, as we talk about, and start the model all over again, right? And then once you have that model state changed to back to the initial state, now I can go ahead and start writing my model because I know the world is blank, right? So I can do that by, for instance, creating a group of new turtles. And one thing that we could do within that that we haven't talked about before is I can immediately ask those turtles to do something. So I can put these little brackets right after a create command, and that's as if you're putting an implicit ask to those turtles I just created. So for instance, I can ask them to set their XY coordinates to random X cores and random Y cores. I could also ask them to change their colors, for instance, so I could set their color to blue. And I can have them change their shape. And we haven't talked about this yet, but NetLogo comes built in with a wide variety of shapes that you can use for your turtles. The standard triangle you've been seeing is the default shape. But if you go up to the Tools menu and then go down to Turtle Shapes Editor, you can see a bunch of other shapes that exist within the system. One that I often use is the person shape. So you can set the shape to person, for instance, and now that I've written this little piece of code, I can hit the check tab, and what the check tab will do is check to see if there's any syntax errors. And right now there isn't, but let's say, for instance, I forgot the hyphen in an X core, random X core, it would tell me that that command doesn't exist, and then I might be like, oh yeah, there's a hyphen there, and once I put it back in, it's okay again. So that allows me now to create my basic first command, and if I go back to the interface tab, right, now I can hit setup, and there you go, I have 100 little people scattered throughout the world. Now, unlike the triangle tabs, the 100 people, the 100 triangle shapes, the people do not have a particular direction they're pointed in, so they're always facing up, even though they are actually facing different directions. It's just the objects themselves are what NetLogo calls non-rotatable. They just stay upright in this particular context. And that's, could be fine. It's up to you as to what kind of shapes you want. If you wanted to change that for some reason, you could go up to the Turtle Shapes Editor, go down to Person, hit Edit, and actually make them rotatable, and that will actually allow them to take on a particular heading. But let's leave it as it is for now. So we have our setup procedure. Let's write our go procedure, and then we'll just write a simple command, ask turtles, forward 5, right random 90 degrees. And now, if we go back to the interface tab, we can type setup, and we can hit go, 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 and we can see him moving. And if you want to see him actually moving a little bit, you can run that slider down, and then you can see them actually moving around a little bit more, right? Now, once we've created these two commands, setup and go, We probably want to interact with them more directly through the interface tab rather than typing setup and go all the time. And we can do that by bringing in two new buttons into the interface tab, which we talked about before. And when we create a button, we just have to talk about what the button is going to, what piece of code the button is going to execute, what command the button is going to execute. So in this case, we want one button that executes setup, and we want one button that executes go. Right? And so now if we hit setup and go, we keep running the commands again. Now one small note, and you can right click or control click to pull up the edit on a button. I could give the actual button name a different name than the command it's executing. So this can be like my cool go, and that's what it'll say, even though it's executing the command go, right? There's no relation between them. If you don't leave anything for the display name, it'll just give the command as the name. There's also a button here called forever. And what forever does is it says, keep executing this command until I push that button again. So if I hit setup now and I hit go, you'll see it just keeps running. And then when I hit go again, it stops the model from running at that particular point. At this point, you probably want to save off your model. So go ahead and go up to file and save. And then you can give your model a name. So I'm going to go over to my desktop and call it, my first model.nlogo. And we might also want to start updating our info tab at the same time, so to explain what's going on, right? So this is my first model to explore NetLogo. And the reason why you want to update the info tab is because you want to make sure that you always have documentation that matches up with the model. One other small note, as you continue to do this, you might even start to do things like my first model to explore NetLogo version 1, right? And then when you make some major changes, you might want to save the new model as my first model -1 or -2. This allows you to kind of keep old versions that you have around. Of course, you could also use a more sophisticated version control system like SVN or Git or something like that as well. Okay, well, that's a basic introduction to how to write code in NetLogo. In the next talk, we're going to discuss how to define properties within that code tab that you can then use within your model.